We are back, guys. It is S2, and we are looking at Team Leonardo with Hobbs, Gorilla, the Nasty One, and Xenophon, the pro team, I would say. And they are up against Team Overdose with Kryptos, Father Xmas, Omicron, and Wings. The random team there, the certainly the skilled team, Overdose, Father Xmas, Kryptos, professional players, as it were, Omicron, Wings, maybe a little less reliable. And certainly not the most experienced in the World War II environment, but we will see how they perform. So like I said, I want to give it to Team Leonardo here, but, you know, again, World War II, everything depends on a couple of clutch plays, and certainly Team Overdose will not be short in that regard. I can see the cannon here has been Overdose holding that for his team, and Leonardo has given it to Gorilla for his team. I think a sound choice there. Gorilla has performed spectacularly with the cannon in the past in a tournament environment. Looks like Plains is underway. Hobbs says victory will be theirs. Overdose wants just one man in the swamps. He wants the rest to go Plains. Perhaps no surprise. I can see, though, that Team Leonardo is much faster on the Plains deploy. Xenophon leading that charge with the Nasty One X. Going to secure those RPGs. Opportunistically spam those. Kryptos and Father Xmas there coming down to prevent this. That's that Overdose cannon against that arsenal. Big spam from Xenophon there against Kryptos. Not too effective though. Father Xmas taking some hits as X comes in to envelop this and is now being supported by Hobbs. Very strong stuff on the Plains. Wings there. That is a huge attack against Father Xmas. Looks like that might have been Xenophon with that one, blowing up all of his units. Hobbs with those RPG attack against Wings. They just need to, Team Leonardo just needs to cut off this reinforcement here, and they might have this game in the bag. Big cannon attack there from Overdose. Doing the work against some of Hobbs' reinforcements, trying to blunt those. Those grenades being tossed. Wings taking some damage there. So Father Xmas was basically annihilated on that attack. Kryptos took some hits as well. And now Team Leonardo is all on the Plains here, and they are in position to go on the Blitz. As you can see, they are getting ready to do that. Wings, the big defense here from Team Overdose. I'm not too sure. This might be overextension from Team Leonardo. Yep, that cannon getting some more kills against Xenophon. Hobbs trying to go in against Omicron. I think this is going to do it, though, for that offense. Gorilla up the mid, though, trying to extend this. Grenade toss. Xenophon and Hobbs being destroyed there. Wings and Father Xmas with Omicron handling that defense. Send in Plains reinforcements if you hand them. Need that muscle, says Kryptos. So I think, yeah, that was too unfortunate for the Team Leonardo attack. They won the Plains and then got overly aggressive there and ran right into that Overdose defense. That's going to do it for a pretty significant differential. 25%, now 20%. As the counterattack is underway from Team Overdose, Omicron up the mid here with Wings. This has got to be Hobbs. No, Xenophon with Hobbs. Putting the heat on Kryptos, the last unit trying to control this arsenal. Xenophon going in for the bayonet, and Hobbs is going to gun down Kryptos there. Which means they'll be able to access this pile. Hobbs will undoubtedly, you know, there's no heals there, but he should probably go back and heal. But anyway, he's going to go for the RPG. He needs a heal, he says. Kryptos asking for a spare. As that close the percentage is quite a bit. 5% lead now for Team Overdose. Kryptos taking pot shots at Xenophon. Cannon still in play on both sides. Looks like Kryptos got destroyed there, though. Gorilla is worried about the cannon, yes. Wings has come up. Team Overdose giving away that lead, though. They are down to one man each, plus their cannon. There's a bit of a counterattack. Well, there was a bit of a counterattack. It was just destroyed there by Father Xmas and Overdose with the defense. Tying this game up. Xenophon and Hobbs trying to make that happen. Delayed planes attack. Tied. No Xenophon. Helpcan still, says Gorilla. He's terribly concerned about this because Omicron is here to persecute this. Wings was destroyed. Omicron tossing his grenades. He needs to go in for the bayonet, but Hobbs will probably block him. And Xenophon. It's all on this cannon game here, and this could be decisive if Omicron can make this bayonet attack against Hobbs. He can't do it, though, and is going to try to go for the cannon with this grenade. Misses that, and now he's in a lot of trouble. He's got Hobbs and Xenophon on him, but the cannon is destroyed there by that attack from Overdose in good time, and that was critical. He also blew up Gorilla, as we saw, and Hobbs. Although had to sacrifice Omicron, he says he's sorry, but I think it was worth it. And Omicron agrees, you're good on that one. So that was the right move from Overdose, a critical cannon attack there. Two men left standing for Team Leonardo with 3 minutes and 47 seconds remaining. Father Xmas is going to walk right through on the planes. No trouble now. One planes, notes Gorilla. Xenophon is moving for the flag. And the Nasty One is sort of heading towards the mid, though, but probably should be going back to counter that Father Xmas attack. Kryptos is going to miss that Zook, but Xenophon will do no damage with the counter Zook. Gorilla saying they got to move fast, and they certainly do. Father Xmas is about to tag out this flag here. Xenophon going in for the bayonet. Takes out Kryptos, is in position to rush this, but it's going to be so close. Xmas is about to be on this flag, and he does it right there. So that was very close. Xenophon, with the final rush, was in position there. As you can see, he'd made it past the defense and could have made that cannon rush, that flag rush, but Father Xmas was there just in time. So they perhaps they should have stopped him. the Nasty One and Xenophon maybe should have prevented Father Xmas from going through there before they went on their final rush. So that will give it to Team Overdose, though I honestly feel like Team Overdose deserved that one. They had a lot of difficulty initially on the planes, as we saw. however, they were sort of, ultimately their defense was able to recover that. The Team Leonardo attack, Xenophon, Hobbs, and Gorilla was so aggressive, and it was defeated stone cold by Wings, Omicron, Kryptos, and Overdose with that cannon. And then Overdose with the spectacular cannon work on the mid, able to take out that Gorilla cannon being held for Team Leonardo, and that sort of put the nail in the coffin there. Team Overdose at that point could just weigh in the artillery if they had to, but luckily they were able to sneak through Father Xmas, who made his move on the flag for the win for Team Overdose. And it was a close game, but a well-played game. And as you can see, that the late game artillery is so critical, and how you exploit those wins. You know, if you go on the all planes and you win it, how do you, you know, arrange an attack? How do you organize offense from that point to move onto the enemy flag without, you know, getting all your men killed? And that was a real problem for Team Leonardo on that one, which Team Overdose showed how to do it with the defense, and then ultimately took it away with a counterattack.